Hey, this is Michael Wilton.
And Todd Latore of Queensryche.
And you're getting your fix of metal injection.
What's up, metal injection junkies? I'm here with none other than Queensryche. First of all, congratulations. In a couple weeks, you're putting out Condition Human, your 15th studio record. That's massive. That's pretty insane, you know, to think about that much history. What would you say is your, you know, one of your favorite memories?
It's a long list. I mean, you know, playing at the Grammys, winning a MTV Music Choice Award, you know, playing at countless, you know, just big festivals, you know, over 100,000 people. There's just so many. I mean, playing, you know, Madison Square Garden, playing Radio City with Iron Maiden. I mean, it's just a list that goes on forever.
Todd, I know it's been a shorter time, but I'm pretty sure you have maybe a favorite memory or two since your time in the band, right?
Yeah, we've gotten to do some amazing things. You know, for me personally, being able to do some of the large festivals in Europe. We got to play Wacken, which was over 75,000 people, touring with bands like Dream Theater and Armored Saint. And I mean, there's a long list of great bands that I've been a fan of. And so being in this band has obviously afforded me wonderful opportunities and experiences to share with these guys. And it's been awesome.
I've heard the new record, and it's amazing.
Okay, good.
Sounds like, you know, the true-to-form classic Queensryche that everybody loves. And even at times, you guys get really heavy, like maybe even heavier than you've ever been before. And I was wondering if there was anything in particular maybe you were listening to or doing that inspired this heaviness out of you.
I think it's just, you know, first and foremost, it's a band again, you know, and you have the cohesive element of everybody's creativity coming in and really influencing the music. And it just, you know, it started to go a certain direction and we were all on the same wavelength. And it's just a matter of, you know, building the songs and seeing where we take them and how they progress. That was kind of an inspiration to bring to Condition Human, but do it in more of a modern setting, you know, a Queensryche 2015, and I think we achieved that.
You also worked with Zeus on this record, and, you know, he's kind of known for, I guess, like extreme metal bands and whatnot, you know what I mean?
With a name like Zeus, how can you not be?
Yeah, really, really. So where did that come from? Like, why did you guys choose Zeus?
He was recommended and referred by Century Media, from someone, you know, at the label. And Michael did some digging and checked him out. And he emailed me and he said, hey, check this guy Zeus out. And, you know, yes, he was very much a part of the metalcore, you know, that whole scene. But sonically, I love what he did with that, you know, the records that he did. And that genre is hard to record and still sound sonically good, because right, there's so much distortion, there's so much drumming, there's the screaming kind of vocals. That's hard to not sound, you know, messy and muddy, and his production was great on that. Plus, he did the new Sanctuary album, and so that's a deviation from, you know, from that other style that he's kind of known for. But he was a huge fan of Queensryche, and he really respected, you know, the legacy of the band and the writing dynamics and qualities that were very indicative of Queensryche's style. The harmony guitars, the certain phrasings, he really pushed all of us to be the best that we could be. And also, you know, Michael was able to use the same amplifiers from those older records. And Eddie Jackson, he used the same bass that he tracked Mindcrime on, or, you know, one of those classic records. And so you're getting tonally that Queensryche.
Yeah.
And but you know, he was really great. We all listened to what he did. We had meetings with him. Everybody was on board. It just seemed like a great thing. And he's a musician also. So there were some songs that, you know, weren't completed that had great elements to them. We said, okay, well, we don't really know where to take these because we've been focused on these other ones. We don't want to throw these away. And so he was able to translate those ideas in pre-production with an instrument and kind of speak that same language as a musician. So that was a big asset for the band to have as well. And he's a super great guy, great sense of humor. And he became kind of a sixth member of the band for those months that we recorded and everything. It was great.
You guys write a lot. You know, I know you write so much that some songs don't even make it to recording. Some you record and don't make it on the record.
He's got so much stuff.
Yeah, I was going to say, well, so what's going to happen with all that music? Are you guys ever going to put it out, or is it never going to see light of day?
I certainly want to hear what he says, but he's given me so much stuff. And it's like, you know, and I say, okay, what am I gravitating toward first? And that's how we're going to get the ball rolling, you know. And but there's a lot of stuff. Well, you've heard the album. So, you know, the end of Condition Human, a little trivia for you. The very ending, where the chanting and everything starts, that was a part of another song that Parker and I worked on. And I loved the song, but everyone in the band didn't really, you know, it didn't stick against the wall when it was thrown against it. Let's just say that.
Right.
But there were elements of that that were great. And so we were able to pull from different parts of that song and create this epic ending to the other song. And so there are bits and pieces that totally, if it's salvageable, we take it. But at some point, you have to put the emotion aside and say, just because I like it doesn't mean it's what's best. And so we want the best of the best.
When we came together for this album,
we had like 25
songs. Yeah, 25 songs that were in demo format, you know, in some form of an arrangement. And, you know, we had to, with the management and the record label and the producer, just get it down to 15 songs. And
right.
So it's an exciting time for the band because everybody is contributing and everybody is being super creative, and we're coming up with some badass music.
We're here, day two of the Scorpions Queensryche tour. What an amazing package. I mean, I'm sure you guys are stoked. What was it like to pull together a set list for something this big?
That's a good question.
Yeah, I mean, it's, first of all, we're so thankful and we love being on this tour because, I mean, for me personally, I grew up listening to the Scorpions. And so it's a really nice treat for me. And, you know, it's a great way to get Queensryche out there again because we're trying to promote the band. And, you know, what better way than these big places like the Barclay Center, which we're in right now. And, you know, it's as far as being in an opening slot, sometimes there's limitations into how many songs you can put in the set list. So, yeah, it's a tough situation.
That's a really great question because when you're promoting a new album, certainly you would want to highlight that. However, this, you know, the Scorpions are sharing their fans with us. Certainly there are Queensryche fans that are coming too, but this is a Scorpion show, and we are the support. And, you know, when you've only got 45 minutes, okay, what's the biggest impact we can make in 45 minutes? So for people that might not be you know, true followers of the band or don't really know what's going on, when they hear the hits, so we're really focusing on the big hits that everyone knows, go, you know, okay, I remember that, and there's a familiarity there, and then you see, you know, maybe we play one new one, or then they have a reason to be reminded, hey, I wonder what they're doing on their own outside of this tour, and then they can dig a little bit deeper into the new album and kind of the Queensryche news. But it's tough when you're breaking down, you know, 30-year catalog the band has into 9 songs.
Yeah.
8, 9 songs, depending, is there an intro, is there a segue, am I going to chit-chat for 10 seconds? You know, you add that up. 1 minute. I mean, we're very mindful of the time limit to not go over. It's a very important schedule. So we're focusing on the big hits, and, you know, we pull some, you know, something that's maybe a little more obscure, but is, you know, like Queen of the Reich or something like that, that's more kind of for the true Queen, the hardcore Queensryche fan or something. You know, it's kind of a best hits thing.
We can't wait to see it. They'll be on tour coming near you. Obviously, go see them and pick up Condition Human coming out in October.
Thank you so much, everyone.